If we want kids to be excited about coming to school, we ought to have some things that look like the real world to them in it.
What they're learning isn't necessarily in this silo by itself, that there are so many interconnections and relationships between all the different things that we're learning, and that's that thinking more holistically is something that is transferable for the rest of their lives.
The digital action plan has been put together by the Ministry of Education of Quebec. They're increasing the resources that we need to have in the schools in terms of equipment and also for training so that teachers and students can better face the technology of today.
So the beauty of the digital action plan is that we have these three different combos. We've got digital devices, educational robotics, and the creative spaces. But really these three parts of the plan are really not so separate. They really work very well together.
Students and parents are using those tools every day. Now what we have to understand is how to use them to learn, because it's very different than just to consume videos and consume information or just browse the internet. It's different than using it to enhance the learning.
Because it's not about the teacher knowing what to do with the technology, it's about the teacher allowing the student to express and discover their learning through technology, not about the teacher teaching the student how to use technology.
Implementing technology in the classroom gives our students the opportunity to fail and to celebrate their failure and learn from that failure and move forward to create and collaborate together so that they can come up with new answers and new ways of thinking.
These students may be solving problems that we don't know exist, or solving problems that they only see exist that will become a bigger problem for, I guess, like our world or society.
Students really have to critically reflect on what they've learned and how they need to communicate it. And so I think that really strengthens what they understand and gives them an opportunity to develop those communication skills that they'll be able to put to work no matter what they do.
So overall, with the digital action plan, what we're gonna see is both a change in mindset and a change in practice.
My role as a teacher in the classroom is to ask a sound, guiding pedagogical question and then allow the students to fly with that and use the technology in any way they see fit so that they can build and create.
So the three combos, they're not stagnant, they're not linear, they're interrelated in so far as you need the devices to be able to operate the educational robotics.
These are the tools that most people use in everyday life. That's pretty much it. Nowadays, even if you're working in a shop, chances are you're gonna be doing some stuff on a computer.
It's a given that children will be using these technologies and new ones that have yet to be developed. They bring so much knowledge with them into the classroom. This allows them to show us what they know and we build from there. So it becomes more of a partnership in our learning as opposed to teacher in front of the classroom telling students what they should know. Instead, there's this beautiful communication between the two happening and we learn together and grow as learners.
Well, the beauty now is the teachers don't necessarily have the answers. We're learning along with the students. We're collaborating together. So we're bringing in these devices and learning together and giving them an opportunity to create and to fail and to rebuild together.